So let us see today our science lesson. Okay. So new lesson, synthetic fibers and fabrics. Okay. See, this is continuation of your earlier class. Because in your 7th standard you read about fibers and fabric. Okay. Fibers and fabric. How we are obtaining the fibers from animal products and then from plant products. Okay. In animal products we get the wool eating animals, that is yak, goat, sheep. Okay, these are all we are getting wools from the that animals, that is wool eating animals. But here let us learn about synthetic fibers. Okay, that is not a natural fibers. In our science 7th standard we read about a natural fibers. Okay, that is fibers and fabrics we are getting, we are obtaining. How we are obtaining the fibers from the natural. Okay, naturally. How we are obtaining the fibers from naturally. That is from animals and plant products. Okay. Now let us see in this class synthetic fibers. What is mean by fiber? First let us know about fibers. So what is mean by fibers? The cloth made up of fabrics. So fibers means the threads. Okay, that is from animals and plants we are getting fibers naturally. But here in artificially we are getting fibers, that is based on the chemical products, that is based on the chemical products. Okay, see, that is fabrics are made up of fibers. Okay, so that fibers here, let us see about the artificially how we are getting. Okay, so it is obtained, so fibers are obtained by naturally and artificially. See, natural fibers and artificial fibers. Sorry children, artificial fibers. Okay, so this natural fibers we are getting from animals and plants. Okay, you all know. Okay, that is very easy. Okay, we can get, that is by animal products and plant products. But here artificially, how we are getting? So by artificially, that is this artificial fibers, we can say it is synthetic fibers. Synthetic fibers are, we can say it as man-made fibers. Okay, synthetic fibers are man-made fibers. So the two types of fibers, one is natural fibers and another one is synthetic artificial fibers. Artificial fibers, we can say this, are synthetic fibers are man-made fibers. Okay, so here let us see about synthetic fibers here. Okay, so what are the types of fibers? Natural fibers and synthetic fibers. What is natural fibers? The natural fibers are obtained from animals and plant products, that is naturally. And synthetic fibers, so these are man-made or called synthetic fibers, and we are getting by the usage of chemicals. Okay, synthetic fibers are made up of small units of chemicals. Okay, small units of chemicals joined together. Okay, synthetic fibers are made up of, that is by the small units of chemicals joined together. Okay, so like a chain. Okay, it includes togetherness. Okay, it forms a fiber. That fiber we can say it is a synthetic fibers. In synthetic fibers also we can have types. Okay, so this synthetic fibers, it forms a chain. Okay, chain we can say it is a polymer. That we can say it is a polymer. Okay, so polymer. Why is the chain form of chemicals? We can say it is a polymer. That polymer, how we can get, means from the Greek word. Polymer means Greek word. Okay, polymer comes from Greek word. Polymer comes from Greek word. Okay. So this we can divide into poly and mer. Okay. okay. So that is synthetic fibers are made up of small units of chemicals. Synthetic fibers are made up of small units of chemicals togetherness. Okay, that we can say it as a polymers. That is synthetic fibers. So polymers, the formation of chain. Okay, the link chain, that we can say it as a polymer. Okay, the formation of chain is called polymers. So how we are joining? That is the small chemicals. Like I will give one example. Okay, we have a pins, paper pins. You know the paper pins, no? How the paper pins are like this? Like this are the paper pins. This paper pins we are joining one by one. Okay, together. So we are joining like this. So we are joining like this, the paper pins. Okay, so this is looks like a chain. Okay, this is looks like a chain. And we are gathering the beads. Okay, we are joining the beads in a thread. Okay, see, we are joining the beads in a thread. We are taking a thread like this, and in that we are joining the beads like this. This is right, children. Okay, we are joining. It is interesting to join, no? So like this, we are joining. We can take a formation of chain. Okay, so like this, the small units of chemicals, okay, the small units of chemicals join together to form a chain like structure. That we can say it is a polymers. That we can say it is a polymer. So how we get the word polymer? From Greek word. Okay, so what is poly means? Many, and mer means units. Okay, so many units joined together to form a structure, that we can say it is a polymer. Okay, so polymer means synthetic fiber. Okay, understood, children? So polymer is a Greek word. We get from Greek word, that is poly means many and mer means units. So many units formed together to form a synthetic fibers. Okay, understood how we are getting a synthetic fibers. Okay, so natural fibers we get from wool. Okay, so from wool, from sheets, yarns, we are getting the hairs of the fleece of the wool eating animals. Okay, fleece of the wool eating animals. Here we don't have any fleece, we don't have any hairs. Okay, so for that we are using the chemicals to make the fibers, synthetic fibers. Okay, that we can say it is a polymers. Okay, see here, polymer occurs in naturally also. Okay, so in synthetic fibers they are not only a man-made. So polymers we can have in naturally also. Okay, why, how we are getting naturally? By cottons. Okay, in a cotton there is a natural fiber cellulose. There is a natural fiber cellulose, that is a synthetic fiber. Okay, so cotton is a polymer. Cotton is a polymer called cellulose. So cellulose is made up of large units, large number of glucose units. Okay, you know that is cellulose. In cellulose glucose units are there. Okay, in large number of glucose units are combined, that is combined togetherness, we get a polymer. Okay, in a cotton plant we get the cellulose. Okay, in that cellulose we have more units of glucose units. More units of glucose units form together to form a polymer. That we can say it is a natural polymer. Example of natural polymer is cotton. Okay, see, example of natural polymer, cotton. See again and again. Okay, don't forget from that. So example of natural polymer, example of natural polymer, cotton. Okay, so next, types of synthetic fibers. Types of synthetic fibers. Synthetic fibers. Okay, how many types of synthetic fibers here? Say
rayon. Okay, rayon. Rayon.
What is the first type of synthetic fiber?
Rayon.
Okay, so these are, keep it in your mind, these are man-made fibers. Synthetic fibers are man-made fibers. Okay, second one. Rayon is the first one and second one, nylon. This is our use, that is the uses of nylons. Okay, we can use by the, we are made up of clothes, socks, curtains, okay, curtains and sleeping bags and then parachutes, etc. We can make by the nylon, that is so many things, is it right? Clothes, okay, clothes, socks, curtains, okay, parachutes, parachutes and sleeping bags. Okay, sleeping bags. These are all the uses of nylon. Okay, the difference between rayon and nylon you get now. Okay, so then we move on to the polyester. So the name itself, we have a chemical name. Okay, so ester. Ester is a chemical name. And poly means many. You know that poly. What does it mean by poly? Poly means many. We can say the word itself polyester. Okay, we can divide this poly plus ester. Poly plus ester. Okay, so poly means many. And ester means we have a chemical product. Okay, so you can learn about ester, that is in your higher classes, briefly in chemistry lesson. Okay, so here let us see about polyester. So what is mean by polyester? Many units, okay, together of chemical products, that we can say polyester. So it is a man-made of material and it is a repeating of, that is poly means many, repeating of many units of the ester, that is chemical products, chemical called ester. So the repeating of many chemical products of ester, chemical units of ester, we can say that is a polyester. Okay, so here there is no natural things. Here we have a wood pulp. Okay, from rayon we have wood pulp. Okay, we are making rayon by the chemical treatment of wood pulp. Okay, so nylon we can have cold water and air. Okay, but here polyester, in here only a chemical product called ester. Many units of chemical product called ester. We can get the polyester. So this is also a cheaper than the natural fiber and it is easy to wash, and it is, this polyester cloths are not wrinkled easily. Not wrinkled easily. Okay. And then so it is a uses we can say, that is shirts, pants and jackets we are using, and bed sheets. Okay, so curtains and sarees, and especially we are using the computer mouse pads. Okay, that also a polyester material. Okay, so these are all the uses. Okay, then polyester is used to make ropes, fabrics for that is conveyor belts. Where they are using conveyor belts? In machines. Okay, in factories they are using conveyor belts for use, that is the use of polyester materials, polyester fabric, and cushioning and insulating the pillows. Cushioning and insulating the pillows also we are using the polyester fabric. Okay, polyester fibers. Okay, so these are all the uses. Polyester is only made up of the chemical called ester. Okay, keep it in your mind. The polyester is only made up of the chemical called ester. Okay, there is no natural things in this. Okay, so next, from the continuation of this polyester, we have so many chemicals used to make the polyester fiber, that is telecord. Okay, these are all we are using, polycord, polywool, etc. We are made from this polyester. Okay, and then PET is the familiar polyester thing, form of polyester, familiar form of polyester. Okay, that is PET. What is mean by PET? Polyethylene tetralate. Okay, polyethylene tetralate. This is the familiar polyester fabric. Familiar polyester fabric. Okay, so this, it is used for making bottles. We are making plastic bottles, plastic cans for use. Okay, so for many purposes we are using. So So that we get made up of PET, polyethylene tetralate. Polyethylene tetralate we are using as a bottles. We are making the polyethylene bottles. Okay, polyester fibers from bottles. Okay, so familiar form of polyester. So utensils, film rolls, wires, we are made up of this from the PET, polyethylene tetralate. Okay, polyethylene tetralate. Okay, and then we move on to the next, acrylic. Okay, so acrylic is also a man-made fiber. This also from the from the chemical treatment of the some chemicals. Okay, chemical treatment by the some chemicals. This is made. This is used for making of wools. Okay, silk materials. So that is blankets. Okay, blankets, curtains. We can use by the acrylic products also. Okay, so this is also made up of synthetic fibers. Okay, so acrylic is also synthetic fibers. Okay, you know the types of synthetic fibers, no? What are the four types of synthetic fibers? Rayon, nylon, okay, and then polyester, acrylic. Acrylic also related to the polyester. It is also made up of a chemical thing. Okay, so it is acrylic is also used for making curtains, okay, blankets, these are all. Okay, and then what are the characteristics of these synthetic fibers? What are the characteristics of these synthetic fibers? Now only we saw, no? So can you remember that? What are the characteristics? So it is a man-made thing. Okay, it is a man-made thing, and these synthetic fibers are very cheaper than the natural fibers. It is very cheaper than the natural fibers, and it is very stronger. Okay, and then it is durable than the natural fibers. See, we can say the synthetic fibers are cheaper, stronger, and durable than the natural fibers. This is